Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Precious Oyeleke. I'm a Nigerian YouTuber. I think about faith, relationship, business tips and various other lovely things that you love to see. So please do well to like, share and subscribe. And if you have not liked my video, please like right now. Just subscribe to the channel and let's grow this channel. Let's grow Oyepearl TV together. So without further ado, let's jump right into today's video. So today I'm going to be asking a question and also answering that question too. Someone asked me some time ago and the person was like, oh, you are single and you are not married, so that means by the time you marry you can change your faith, and you know, yeah, your husband religion is your religion. Like that's the exact way the person said it. Your husband religion is your religion. I was like, please, my husband religion is not my religion. That is why, as a lady, I have the right to choose who I am to marry and marry somebody that is of the same faith with me. And I was like, no, if your husband, let's say your husband is a Muslim, I will have to convert to a Muslim because I'm marrying him, and my husband really is a Muslim. I think in the first instance, that is why I will not even bother marrying a Muslim. I will marry a Christian, someone that we share the same faith together. And they're sharing the same faith together, that also understand the principles of the scriptures, that I understand so many principles. Don't come and scatter my edge. So that now start telling me that, no, even within the same Christianity, some can be like, oh, you take God too serious. I'm not a church type. Please, I am a church type. I am a God type. I am all the type that is found in Christ. I am all the type. You will see me there. I am that type. So the person was asking, that means your husband religion is your religion. I said, sorry to disappoint you, sir. My husband religion is not my religion. Yes, it's my religion if we share the same faith. But if we don't share the same faith, what will I even be with you in the first instance? So that leads me to a question I'll be asking you, my viewers. Is your husband religion your religion? Or if you're a man, is your wife religion your religion? Please comment right now before I even continue this video. Go and make a comment and let me hear your opinion about it. That is your husband religion your religion? Or is your girlfriend religion your religion? Or your boyfriend religion your religion? Please do well to answer that question in the comment box below. So let me continue the video. When the man was asking me, I was shocked. Then that question that started bringing out so many thoughts within me, and I was like, how will my husband religion be my religion? No, it's not possible. That is why, really, ladies, the scripture says that we submit to our spouse, to our husband, in all things, and we are left with the right, with the ability to choose whom to marry. That means, as a lady, I have the right to choose who I'm to marry, who I'm to spend the rest of my life with. So since I know I have that right, and God have left me with that choice, I am to choose someone that we align together. And the scripture says in 1 Corinthians, and do not be unequally yoked with an unbelievers. Please, it is not a question of yes or no. Also, can start changing your mind that what's there? If the guy loves you, if he's pampering you, giving you money, that means you should marry him. Or he's not telling you that, oh, you should marry me because I'm taking care of you, because I love you, I will allow you to do your faith. Please don't put me through that stress. No, it is not possible. I don't want. The scripture says that do not be unequally yoked with an unbeliever, period. Don't stress it to the front. Don't argue it too much. Because if you're unequally yoked with an unbeliever, you know the spirit of God, you know, God is our father, is our spiritual father. And the scripture says that anyone that is not in Christ, that is not born again, is spiritually dead. So the person is spiritually dead. So why will I marry somebody that is spiritually dead, that you are not sharing the same fatherhood? And so if there is any issue, who will I report the person to? Whether I report the person to the devil? No, I can't put the person to God because we're not sharing the same lineage. We're not from the same lineage. We're not from the same family. We're not from the same roots. So the scripture have even said it all. Do not be unequally yoked with an unbeliever. So any lady out there or any guy out there, no matter the love you have for that lady, no matter the love you have for that guy, please. And the guy is not the same faith with you. People are not of the same faith. I mean Christians. Together, please, flee. Flee, it's not wrong though. Please flee. Because the scripture have answered it. So what's not like, oh, he will take care of you, he will pamper you, he will do this, he will do that. Please tell him that no. And please just say it with all honor and respect. I'm so sorry, it is not possible. It can't work out. If it is asking, just it just can't work out. I'm just asking why, please if we're not of the same faith. So it's that just made issue. Like, you know, when you are like trying to look for who to get married to, and some people are like asking that, oh, what are the criteria that you look out for? See, one major criteria that the scripture had even helped us and shown us the light about it is about the faith of our spouse. When the lady said, do not be unequally yoked with an unbeliever, don't help God to argue. Mm-mm. It was in the scripture for a reason. It was in the scripture. If it was not in the scripture, then we can have things to be like, oh, I can marry anybody because God has created everybody. But since you know it is in the scripture, you're like, okay, God created everybody, yes. But am I to marry everybody? No. So please, when my husband said that, your husband religion is your religion. I was like, no, sir. My husband religion. Because that man was trying to be like, oh, you can marry, let me say, you can marry a Muslim, you can marry any person from any belief. I said, even if the guy is a Buddhist, he loves me, he can die for me, he will pamper me, he will take me to Jamaica, to Europe, to everywhere, and we are not of the same faith. You see, if I'm already liking him, immediately that love, that likeness or that love will die. I will kill it. Like, that is it. Because I can't stress my future self because of the pleasure of now. I'm not forget the future. And I forget the future. Because we as Christians, the nature I have will be different from the nature that he has. Me, I have nature of love. Yes, it might be nice, might be caring, but nice is not the fruit of the Spirit. It's caring, not the fruit of the Spirit. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, patience. And that is the nature on the inside of me. That is what I exhibit naturally because I am a Christian and I believe in the Lordship of Christ. So please and please, when somebody tells you as a lady that, oh, your husband's religion is your religion, please tell the person back that that statement should not push me to marry and not believe. Because they've used that statement in coining so many ladies to marry someone not of the same faith with them. So it's not a Christian. Let me talk to the Christians. I'm not a Christian. They'll be like, if you marry, I'm a guy, I'm like, okay, I can marry a Muslim, I can marry a, if I worship a person, go worship a Buddhist, an atheist. Since I'm a guy, I'm a Christian, doesn't mean anything. I will bring her to Christ. Please, God will not give you that mission to now convert your spouse. If you want to do evangelism work, please, there are so many places in the world that God needs their souls for the kingdom, that their souls need to be won from the kingdom of God. Please go to those regions. Don't do that. Don't do that, please. Please, don't be like, oh, because I'm a guy that's I can marry anybody and I will convert. She has to come to my religion. No. No, because this one is converting because her husband instructs her to convert to Christianity. If later on along the line, she's not deeply grounded and rooted in Christ, or start falling in love with Christ and start studying the scriptures and start getting understanding by herself, she's not a Christian. Because she'll be like, why are you a Christian? Because my husband is a Christian. Nah, that is not how it's meant to be. So please, if you like somebody, love somebody, and a person on the same faith with you, win the person to Christ, not with the aim to marry the person, but with the aim that the person is to join the kingdom of God. Because here, I didn't know the person being in Christ first. Every person now in Christ, I'm like, okay, now she's not in Christ and she's growing. If the Holy Spirit is still not leading you to that same sister, that is where you should go ahead and meet her. If the Holy Spirit is not leading you to that sister again, please, move. I was in some message some time ago, a lady that was like, when she entered school in 100 level, she was not long. She had dating a brother in church, but that's still a Christian too. And then she had not really grown because she just came out to Christ, she's not really doing anything. So she was not, and they've been dating from 100 level to 100 level. When she was at 300 level, she started taking her Christian faith more serious, taking her walk with Christ more serious, and understanding the scriptures. Then she realized that at that moment in her life was not for relationships. She needs to fellowship more with her father. She needs to discover her purpose. She needs to walk more with God. Do you know what she did? She had to go and meet the guy. I'm so sorry. Yes, I plan to marry you. Yes, you plan to marry me. But at this level of my life right now, relationship is not what I need. The guy was shocked. And this is when they are both of the same faith. So like, I just got converted when I entered into university and I thought that, oh, because no, the scripture said that I don't be unequally yoked with an unbeliever, and because we're both Christians, I did not see any issue with it. That Singapore Christian let us to go ahead and date. So and she said that later along the line, I'm going to realize that I have not discovered my purpose. I don't know what I want to do in my life, and I'm here with somebody. Like, in the first instance, my purpose should be the one to influence who I am to marry and who I am to spend the rest of my life with. Because if I have no purpose, then what am I looking for in a relationship? If you're like, oh, my husband will complete me, are you done completing yourself? You are old. He is old. It is 1 + 1, not half plus half. 1 + 1/2. 1 + 1 that will equal 1. Not 1 + 1/2. Not 1 and 1. That's not the question we are dealing with here. So, sorry, please. So, I'll be putting this out there that please, as ladies, as guys, please marry someone of the same faith with you. The scripture has said it all. Do not be unequally yoked an unbeliever. And if you do that, you already solve like some issues already. Then I need to know about small areas. I need to know, okay, is purpose, is it teachable, is it lovable, does it obey God, does it follow God's instructions? And I'm going to follow those ones to now know who to spend the rest of your life with. So if you have been blessed and edified and instructed by this video, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe and share these videos to your friends, to your loved ones, to people that you know that they need to hear these. I am talking to the person about it. Just share the link to that person and watch it transform people's life around. I will see you guys in my next video. Enjoy the rest of your day.